What's up guys, welcome back. I'm Lorena from Green Healthy Cooking and today we're making a crockpot lentil soup. So this is one of those amazing recipes that you can throw together in the morning and then you come home from work to the most amazing dinner ever. So you don't have to soak your lentils or beans or legumes in general, but they're much easier to digest when you do. So I suggest that you take a cup of green lentils, a cup of red lentils, and a cup of cannellini beans, and you put them in a large bowl and soak them in abundant water for as long as possible and up to 12 hours. So I always soak them overnight, but if you can only soak them for 2 hours, that's already better than nothing. So put them in abundant water and set them aside and then get your veggies out. You're going to want to super finely chop one onion and you're also going to want to chop 2 cloves of garlic very finely. And then you want to dice some carrots until you have about 1 cup of diced carrots. And you want to dice some celery until you also have about 1 cup of celery. Now set all your veggies aside and bring out the crock pot. Now add all your veggies to the crock pot and also your legumes. Before you add your lentils and cannellini beans, you're gonna have to drain them and rinse them. And once you rinse them, you're going to add them to your veggies in the crock pot. And now we're gonna add some spices. So we're going to add 1 tablespoon of fresh thyme. If you don't have fresh thyme, then use just 1 teaspoon of dry thyme. Sea salt, the amount will depend on how seasoned your broth will be, the broth that you're going to add in a minute. So try your broth before you add it so you know how much salt you're gonna have to add. My broth is salted, so I'm only adding 1 teaspoon of sea salt, a little bit of pepper, and then we're gonna add some spice, some chili powder, anywhere from 1/2 teaspoon to 1 whole tablespoon, depending on how spicy you like it, of course. Since I'm going to share this lentil soup with my kids, I'm going to add only 1/2 teaspoon, so it's not going to be spicy at all. Now we've added all our spices and it's time to add the broth. If you want this recipe to be vegetarian, then of course use some vegetable broth. If you are omnivore, I recommend some chicken bone broth because it's very, very flavorful. So add your broth, add your lid, set your crock pot to 8 hours on low or 4 hours on high and let it do its job. Now for the toppings at the end, I strongly suggest, if you're omnivore, to make some crispy bacon. I love baking my bacon because it keeps the mess kind of contained. For that, I have these silicone bacon racks, if we want to call them that. I put them on a baking sheet. I place my bacon strips on top so all the excess fat can drizzle to the bottom. I place them in a 400 degree preheated oven for anywhere from 20 to 25 minutes, depending on how thick your bacon is. Please keep an eye on it because nobody wants burnt bacon, right? So if you have very, very thin breakfast bacon, then 15 minutes might be enough. So please keep an eye on it. And once it's nice and brown, you're gonna take it out of the oven, let it cool down completely. If you want, you can use some paper towel and pat all the excess fat off. And then you're just gonna use your hands to crumble up the bacon and set it aside until your lentil soup is finished. Now, after 8 hours or 4 hours on high, your lentils and cannellini beans will be completely cooked through and mushy and delicious, and you're gonna have this chunky soup. It's time to serve it in a bowl, sprinkle some of that crispy bacon on top, some freshly chopped parsley, and dive in. I swear, this is one of my favorite soups. I know I say that every time, but it's so good. I hope you give this recipe a try. If you do, please don't forget to snap a picture. I want to see, I want to know how you liked it. And if you're wondering how to make this crockpot lentil soup in the Instant Pot, I'll see you in my next video. Bye.